Hi there, my name is Christina Halsted. I'm a 2D animator currently living in Burbank, California. My training is in traditional hand-drawn animation, and I've been using Toon Boom for about a year and a half, using it for both digital hand-drawn animation and for puppet animation. In this series of tutorials, I'm going to show a little bit about the interface, and the first thing we're going to talk about here is a little bit about the interface and the tabs and windows. And so you'll see that when you first open up Essentials, it'll be set up like this. This is the default workspace. You'll see that you have about four different module windows going on right now. You got this big one right here, two right here, and the long one for the timeline. The cool thing about Toon Boom is that you can really customize your workspace quite efficiently. Obviously, you saw me drag around some bars here. These will let you move your spaces around. And the way these windows work is they center basically around the fact that you've got little tabs in each of your windows. And you can move those around, add, and delete them to have your workspace kind of just be the way you want it to. So in this case, I do like the fact that I've got camera and drawing view up here. And I've got some other side properties over here. I generally like to have my color up here. So what I can do to move that, and you can see that builds up a couple of different, kind of mocks up other things you can do, but if I want to move a tab, I just take the tab and drag it up to the other tabs in the area I want it to go. And now my color tab is up here. And actually this tab just completely disappeared. If I want to delete a tab, I click on it and then hit the little X. Each of these boxes has a plus and an X. So let's say I want to move some more stuff around. Let's say I want to take my tool properties and make a new window. And I can just do it just like that by dragging it to a space that'll kind of prompt you with a little blue box. I'm going to move my library down there too. And I'm going to add my layer properties. I like this little kind of setup right here. You can also change the general pattern of the boxes. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to take away this box down here that had my timeline. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add my timeline again up here. And I'm going to drag it down here so that it pops up like this. That way, these two boxes have the full length of the screen, and these two boxes have the full length of this screen. And that's pretty much how you move your windows around.